Right, we're going to talk about the bandsaw. So you notice I have an apron on, which is going to cover my tie. I could also take off my tie. I need to roll up my sleeves so that my sleeves don't get caught. I know most of you guys aren't ever wearing a long sleeve shirt, but just in case you are, say it's a formal dress day, you need to be sure that your sleeves are out of the way. If you have a tie on, you want to have that tie out of the way, right? I also have a watch on, so I need to take that watch and go ahead and remove that as well. So that's all just so I don't get sucked into a machine by something that isn't part of my body, right? So a lot of times you'll see, I might yell at you if I see you wearing gloves with any of these tools, because if you're wearing gloves, you have no idea where your fingers are, right? And we want to keep all our fingers. So I got safety glasses on. I have prescription glasses and I have side shields for them that I normally wear. I couldn't find them, so I'm wearing safety glasses. So I'm all set. I'm nice and safe. I want to check the space around where I'm going to work to make sure there's nothing dangerous there I'm going to trip on or whatever. So if I want to take this piece of wood and cut on the bandsaw, a couple things to know about the bandsaw. The bandsaw is called a bandsaw because the saw blade is like a big band. So I have one over here. I actually have a couple. Oh. There we go. So this is a bandsaw blade, right? So it looks like a big band, like a rubber band. So the band goes around these two wheels here. So as it moves, you can cut material. There's a motor down here that actually powers it. And this just tracks along. There's bearings and everything else that you need to have set up properly. The bandsaw blades come in different thicknesses. So anywhere from about an eighth of an inch, or maybe not an eighth, sorry, that'd be pretty small, quarter of an inch, to up to an inch. Not so much for this one. This one, probably the biggest it makes is 3/4 inch, but they make bigger bandsaws. So the wider the blade is, the straighter the cut's going to be. But the smaller the blade is, the more you can turn it. So a bandsaw is really good for making quick cuts. It's not the best for making perfectly straight cuts, but it is excellent for making curved shapes. So I'm going to show you how to set up the saw, and then I'm going to do a quick little cut. So I thought that might be still open. So what I want to do is I want to raise the blade guard. This is the blade guard. There's a knob right here. And then on the backside here is a knob I can raise it. So this knob releases it. This one raises and lowers it. So I'm going to stick my material I want to cut. Oh, there's some scrap left in. I want to get rid of that. I'll let this fall all the way. I'm going to raise it up. I'm going to stick my pinky right there, right? And just the tip of my pinky. And then I'm going to lock it in. What I want is I want this piece of wood to be able to go up and down just a little. I don't want it like this because there'll be a lot of flex here. And I won't make a straight cut. And I also don't want it like this, so that's really tight. Because anytime anything's really tight, when you're woodworking, you have a much better chance of pushing too hard, and then you're going to cut your finger, which you definitely don't. All right, so now I'm ready to cut. The first cut I'm going to do is a straight cut. So when I go to do that, I'm just going to eye it. So the blade's right here. I'm going to turn it on, and I'm going to cut it. Now, what I don't want to do is have my thumbs right here so that when I cut, I'm going to cut my thumbs. So I want to hold it on both sides. I'm going to let it slide, and I want to be sure I'm letting the saw do the work. So I don't want to be pushing really hard. I want it to actually cut. Now it's going to take a second to wind down. I wanted to keep this piece here. I won't have a problem cutting all along here because I can cut in. I should be able to make this turn and then I could cut out and then come back in. But if I wanted to cut and save this piece, then making this first turn is going to be really hard. So what I would do is I would come out with the saw and cut like that first to give myself a relief. So this little piece will come off. I can move in, probably do another one here. So cut that there. It gives me a place to turn. I can turn and maybe I'll give myself another one there. I may not need that one. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that so that you can see. And it doesn't matter that I'm a little off on these lines, since this is just my waste material. So I want to go just up to that line, then I cut my curve. So that piece comes off, so I drop. Now that gives me room to move. Then I'll come to the second one. Must not have went as far as I thought. See how it's already getting way easier. So having that little bit of room makes a big difference. I think my problem is the line is pretty thick. There we go. Now I can turn it around, come from the other direction. And sometimes it's fine to do it with one hand. So it's not perfect, but it's close. Another thing that's important is sometimes, see this piece of wood? I don't want to grab it with my hand, but I can use another piece of wood to move it. Occasionally, you're cutting a very small piece, and what you'll use is what's called a push stick, a little bit bigger stick, and you can put it in to the wood, to the saw. That's the basics of the bandsaw. I'll, of course, show everyone how to use this, so you'll get to know it pretty well. It's one of the best tools in the shop.